And good evening, everybody. You know, before Oakland went on this amazing streak, they were in third place in the AL West. Now they're in first, celebrating baseball's longest winning streak in 49 years. The A's looking for number 18. This game goes back and forth, Twins and A's tied at two, until John Mabry strikes one. His home run to center breaks the tie, A's the lead. Twins thought they'd snap the A's streak with back-to-back home runs in the ninth. Oakland found itself trailing by one with one out in the ninth, and that's when Miguel Tejada becomes the Bay Area's favorite son. A three-run walk-off home run as the A's win it. They win again, 7-5 was your final. On the American League board, Toronto was a win over New York. Boston by six on top of the Tribe. Chicago shuts out the Tigers. Seattle beat Kansas City. Anaheim over Baltimore, and Tampa Bay beat Texas 8-3. National League, it's the Dodgers visiting the Astros. Not a bunch of offense in this game. Baseball purists would love it. Dodgers smack in the game-winning run in the second, but really the story was Hideo Nomo's on, who struck out eight. He's lost only once in his last 21 starts, dating back to mid-May. Nomo carried the Los Angeles Dodgers today, gave up one run and five hits. And how about this, Eric Gagne, he worked the ninth for his, 46th save. He's always fun to watch. Dodgers beat the Astros 2-1. World champion Diamondbacks fell behind 5-0. Giants leading. Arizona rallies. Who's going to be the hero in the desert? Dave DeLucci, bases loaded, two-run double in the ninth, lifted the Snakes to a 7-6 win. Arizona was in jeopardy of being swept at home for the first time this season. Mets are terrible. They matched the longest home losing streak in history of the league. They fell behind Philadelphia 9-5. In fact, that was the final score, dropping their 14th in a row at Shea Stadium. It's a major league record. It's 20 set by the St. Louis Browns. Now, it was batting practice for the Phillies, who made easy money this weekend. On the National League board, San Diego was a win over Colorado. Chicago by one on top of St. Louis. Atlanta by two over Montreal today. Florida doubles up Pittsburgh. And Milwaukee, 4-2 winners over the Reds. Las Vegas 51s close out the regular season Monday night at Cashman. Afternoon game with Sacramento today. Hey, there's Brad Mills, your Pacific Coast League Manager of the Year. He'll be awarded that honor on Monday. Rivercats jumped out to a 5-1 lead. The deep shot to left center field. It is off the wall. Scores three runs. Though Las Vegas bounced back, lots of runs scored in this game. In fact, more runs in this game than last night's Rebel Badger football game. Phil Hyatt smacks this home run. Rivercats beat the 51s. Check it out, 20-13. Dodgers called up Joe Thurston, David Ross, Wilken Ruhan, and Jeff Williams. Well, the air is thin in Canada. Henderson's Craig Barlow birdies the ninth hole. He's tied for third. David Gossett, though, comes up. He's going to be on 13 here. His approach shot could be, and really, perhaps it maybe should be. Look at this. It tracks toward the hole. He has to settle for the bird. Steve Lowry shooting for the tie. Yeah, just can't get it. The winner of the tourney this year, Gene Sowers, who closed with a 2-under, 69. NFL season begins this week, so with our season debut of the early line, here is Art Manteris from Station Casinos.
Chris, happy to be back with you at Channel 8. Happy to see football season underway already. Some great finishes and some really bizarre endings in college football. But next week, the NFL starts for real. Thursday night, 49ers at the Giants. 49ers have opened as a three-point favorite. Sunday afternoon, one of the best games of the day, the Rams at the Denver Broncos. Rams are -2.5. And Monday night, really good game. Two teams that will probably compete for the AFC Championship, Steelers at the New England Patriots. We open the Steelers a one-point favorite. Here's the rest of next week's NFL games.
All right, thank you very much, Art. We appreciate that. We're not finished with football, though. When we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about the Rebels. Have they turned over a new leaf? Well, they certainly turned out the lights. We're going to visit with Las Vegas Sun sportswriter Steve Guiremand. He joins us next right here on Sports Sunday. All righty, and welcome back. Before we talk Rebel football, let's check out today's top 25 action. Blacksburg, Virginia. They retired Michael Vick's number. Now, they can't put the number in mothballs just yet. That's because, hey, Kevin Jones wears that number. Here he is, right side for the score. Tigers, oh, yeah. Virginia Tech's happy. Tigers, not very happy. Football expert Lee Corso picked LSU to play for a national title. Probably won't happen this year. Guess what? The Tigers fall and fall hard. It's the Hokies winning 26-8. Tech pulls off the mild upset, but check this out. Some thought Louisville would perhaps shake up the BCS, but they lose to unranked Kentucky 22-17. All right, now it's time to talk football, UNLV football. Our guest tonight is Las Vegas Sun sports writer Steve Guiremand. Thank you very much for being here tonight.
Thank you for
having
me. I got
to ask you, Steve, first of all, right off the bat, the power going off there at Sam Boyd was so bizarre, wasn't it?
It was a surreal night out at Sam Boyd. I think from start to finish, the game, I don't think, went anywhere close to way. I think a lot of people figure it would be a up and down high scoring game and a lot of turnovers, an ugly game, and then whammo, the lights go out. You don't see that every day.
It was the proper thing to do, I think, though. Robinson was saying, you know, the players get cool and they cool down and so forth to say, hey, you know what, we're not going to win this thing. Let's just call it.
Yeah, and I think, you know, he even admitted it would have been like a TKO in boxing. You know, they really didn't have much of a chance to pull this one out. You know, it was a deal where the lights, I don't think, ever really did come back on. Even after they canceled the game, an hour later, it was still the emergency lights, and those weren't good enough to play the game.
Another thing that I'm sure made a lot of people upset was the fact that all bets are off in terms of betting. All those Wisconsin fans in town, hey, they don't win, they don't lose, they go home. I mean, that was kind of weird.
Yeah, I think they still enjoyed themselves quite a bit, judging by the number of Budweiser bottles we had to step over to get in the locker room afterwards.
Let's talk a little bit about the football game. You take away that second quarter, perhaps UNLV is right there, but boy, Jason Thomas out of the blocks just didn't have a good game.
Yeah, second year in a row where Jason, I don't know if it's stage fright or just too fired up for the game, but, you know, he had looked so much better in summer conditioning and fall camp. So his fundamentals were much better, and then, you know, like this last play here where he kind of tried this shovel pass, you know, there were a couple center exchanges, a couple key fumbles. You know, it was obviously not his brightest moment, and, you know, he heard his share of boos again from the Sam Boyd crowd.
He says the team's behind him. I know the coaches are behind him. You know, John Robinson, after that ball game, talked a little bit about Jason Thomas and the four turnovers, and it was kind of unique what he had to say. Listen to what he had to say right here.
Jason Thomas was involved with those, as your quarterback always is. I think he came back and played a lot better as the game went on. You know, he's got that, there's something there that, you know, obviously it isn't all over. We have to continue to work on that.
Steve, what's your take on that when he says he has to continue to work on that?
Well, I think coach is a little frustrated too. I mean, this is the third year he started, only the second guy in UNLV history to start three straight openers, and you would expect as a fifth-year senior that, you know, by now the fundamentals and, you know, the guy who's going to be your leader would come out and take charge right off the bat and maybe the biggest game of the decade. And it's struggling. It wasn't just JT. I don't think everybody should. The quarterback and the coach always get a lot of the blame, but, you know, it definitely was not what I think most people expected out of the gate.
They put so much work into this summer conditioning, working out with each other, the receivers, the running backs, and so forth. And you know, one guy I'm excited about, and I know the fans here in Las Vegas will be thrilled with this guy, is Larry Croom.
Yeah, I thought Larry showed signs of what he can do in this game. He, you know, he's a 10-500 meter guy from Long Beach Poly with some real nice moves, and I think he's going to have a big year before it's all said and done.
What about the defense? Coach Robinson afterward talked about the defense, and really they shut down their star running back, the Badgers, 80 yards on 20 carries, whatever. But the defense played well.
Yeah, I thought, you know, they did, I thought, better than I expected against Anthony Davis, who had almost 180 yards, I think, against Fresno the week before. Pretty good Fresno State team. You know, Jamal Wynn got beat on a couple deep passes in one-on-one coverage, but that's going to happen to him, Kevin Thomas and stuff, too. I think their defense, you know, showed signs that they're going to keep them in a lot of games this year.
And what about the cornerbacks? The defense, I guess, overall is shifty. They're quick. They're fast.
Yeah, and I thought defensive line held their own against a line that some people thought was one of the top two or three best in the country. And for them to go head-to-head against Wisconsin and hold their own, I thought was a real plus for UNLV.
Steve, we've got about 30 seconds. Let me ask you about the game coming up now. They got Kansas in town this weekend, a very beatable team.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt. You know, coaches hate to say must win, but they need to put out a decent performance this week or there's going to be a lot of angry Rebel fans out there.
Can you give me a prediction?
Put me on the spot. I don't know. UNLV 27-14.
Something like that. There we go. I appreciate you coming in tonight, Steve. Thank you very much. That is Steve Guiremand from the Las Vegas Sun. We appreciate him joining us tonight here on Sports Sunday. Don't forget, next Saturday, the Rebels home with Kansas. Until next week, good night, everybody.